Welcome to another edition of the Carolina Bay of the Day, where we study the secondary impacts made by the glacierized boulders that were ejected by an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. Fintel Basin is one of the elliptical geological features called Nebraska Rainwater Basins. These basins have many characteristics in common with the Carolina Bays, including the orientation of their major axis toward the Great Lakes. Michael Davias named this bay Fintel Basin after an historic landowner because the U.S. Geological Survey had not given a name to this gentle depression found 8 kilometers due south of Sutton, Clay County, Nebraska. Unlike many other bays that hold standing water and attract wildlife, this basin has an extensive natural drainage network that directs the water toward a break at its eastern rim. The basin is under agricultural use and it is crossed by local roads. No buildings seem to be present in the area. There are many misconceptions about what the Carolina Bays are, and geologists sometimes have even lumped them together in the same category as the thermokarst lakes in Alaska, which are sinkholes filled with water. In 2015, I wrote a definition that takes into consideration the origin of the bays as secondary impacts from the ejecta of an extraterrestrial impact on the Laurentide ice sheet. The Carolina Bays are shallow elliptical depressions with raised rims on unconsolidated ground whose major axis is oriented toward the Great Lakes region. The prototypical Carolina Bays are elliptical in the mathematical sense and they have an average width-to-length ratio of approximately 0.58. Carolina Bays only occur within a radius of 1,500 kilometers from the Great Lakes. The definition of the Carolina Bays emphasizes the elliptical geometry of conic sections, the raised rims characteristic of impact craters, and the radial orientation toward the convergence point of origin by the Great Lakes. The ejecta from the extraterrestrial impact had a range of about 1,500 kilometers from the impact point, and the width-to-length ratio of approximately 0.58 corresponds to impact angles of about 35 degrees. Carolina Bays are only found in the United States from about the Rocky Mountains to the Atlantic coast. Using graphic tools, we can easily demonstrate that Fintel Basin has an elliptical geometry. With Google Earth, we determined that Fintel Basin is located 1,220 kilometers from Saginaw Bay, which is the convergence point calculated by Michael Davias for the Carolina Bays and Nebraska Rainwater Basins. The LiDAR image also shows the raised rims, so Fintel Basin meets all the requirements of a Carolina Bay. LiDAR images are essential for the study of the Carolina Bays. The description of this video has a link to the LiDAR image visualization tool by Michael Davias in the Carolina Bay of the Day. Compared with the LiDAR image, a topographic map of the same area from the U.S. Geological Survey looks almost like a blank sheet of paper with a few squiggly lines. A satellite view of Fintel Basin shows almost no distinguishing features because the terrain is very flat. We can only see Nebraska's system of roads that divides the land into a grid of 1 mile squares. We know that the bay is there, but without a LiDAR image, we cannot see it. The LiDAR images provided by Michael Davias are very valuable for studying surface features. The LiDAR images integrate seamlessly with Google Earth. This makes it possible to generate a transect along Highway NE41. The transect shows that the rim is about 2.5 meters higher than the surface of the bay. Using Google Maps, we can get a street view of the east rim of Fintel Basin along Highway NE41. The view of the east rim of Fintel Basin from Highway NE41 does not look remarkable. If you don't see anything except the young corn plants on either side of the road, that is normal. A 2.5 meter Carolina Bay rim will look just like a small hill. If you pay close attention, the image shows the place where the rim was cut in order to build the highway. When exploring the Carolina Bays, we have to become aware of these very subtle land features. Fintel Basin has a width of 1,950 meters and a length of 2,800 meters, and it is located 523 meters above sea level. The Nebraska rainwater basins are elliptical because they originated as inclined conical cavities. The width-to-length ratio of 0.696 corresponds to an impact angle of 44.1 degrees. Viscous relaxation reduced the depth of the cavities to create the shallow elliptical bays that we see today. The study of the Carolina Bays is not complete unless it also includes the Nebraska rainwater basins. Northerly storms from Canada have eroded many of the Nebraska rainwater basins, but we will continue to examine them one bay at a time. Please subscribe to be notified of future videos about the Carolina Bays.